Good morning, students. We have studied that when white light enters through a prism, it deviated into its 7 constituent colors. Today we will discuss what happens when this white light enters in another prism. So students, see here. We have taken 2 prisms. One is PQR, another is just upright down opposite to this. For first prism, QR base, and second prism, just you see, base is upwards, Q dash R dash. So we have taken 2 prisms which is just opposite to each other. When white light enters through PQR, it dispersed into its 7 constituents color. Red color deviates least, violet color deviates most, and this constituents color, when enters into another prism, it recombine and comes out or emerges out with white light. So when white light enters from one prism, it deviates, and again that deviated colors enters in another prism, white light comes. One example just I am showing you. After rain, suppose a water droplet is scattering in the atmosphere. When sun comes, sun rays falls on this water droplets, light changes its medium, refraction occurs, and it dispersed into its 7 constituent color. When this 7 constituent color strikes the opposite faces of these drops, its properties of totally internal reflection follows. So it totally internally reflected. And when it comes again at another surface of the raindrops, it just deviates into its 7 constituent color. And this 7 constituent color is nothing but we are seeing it as rainbow. So you see here just violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. So rainbow color is vibgyor, and this is the formation of rainbow. So in the formation of rainbow, 3 phenomena occurs. First is refraction. Second is total internal reflection. And third is dispersion. Okay.